Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel. I'm Juliana and I'm so excited to be showing you how to make rolled marshmallow fondant. You only need four easy ingredients and one of them happens to be my favorite, marshmallows. So we're gonna go ahead and take 16 ounces of mini marshmallows and place them in a bowl. You wanna be sure to use a fresh bag of marshmallows because it will help in the long run when you're kneading it out if you have a fresh bag, and it'll also help the taste. We're gonna add 2 tablespoons of water right into the marshmallows. This is the point where you would want to add any coloring if you wanted your entire batch to be colored, and then you would just give it a stir. So we're going to put this in the microwave for 30-second increments on high, stirring after each 30 seconds. You're going to want to do this for about 2.5 minutes until everything is smooth. Now that this is melted and super sticky, we are going to add in about 3/4 of the 8 cups of sifted powdered sugar into the mixture. We're going to add the sifted powdered sugar in increments. Now's the time to add the flavoring. Fondant is usually vanilla flavored, but you can add whatever flavoring you'd like. Just keep in mind that it is really messy, so you wanna know that going into it. If you're gonna make a mess, just have fun with it. If you thought this was messy, the next part's gonna be really fun. So the powdered sugar did our job for us already. It already got everywhere. So next we're gonna put some shortening on our hands. You wanna get it everywhere. It's a little gross, but it's kind of fun. And then we want to put some all over the table in your workspace. Nice and greasy. Now that we're all greased up, we're gonna dump the powdered sugar and marshmallow mixture onto the workspace so we can knead it out. It's gonna get really messy. But be careful because your hands are slippery, so you don't want to drop your bowl or your spatula. It's kind of better just to go in with your hands. All right. Don't tell mom you're making a mess in the kitchen. Mom, I need your help. So now is when we start kneading the dough, and you're gonna knead, oh, there we go. Nice and smooth, see, that's what the shortening does. So we're gonna knead this just like you would any other dough. And you wanna get it so it's a nice, smooth, elastic consistency. We sifted the powdered sugar beforehand because as you might be able to tell when you're doing this, it'll form little balls of powdered sugar, so doing the work in the front kind of helps you right now. So as you can see, it's starting to stick to everything. Looks like I need more shortening. You like that? Puns? Puns are the best kind of jokes. We're also gonna add some powdered sugar too, to kind of just incorporate the powdered sugar as well as keep it from sticking. And then work it in so you can make it a smooth, elastic consistency. Look at that. I think I need more shortening. Well, I think we've had enough fun for one day. We're gonna go ahead and store this in the refrigerator overnight before we can start working with it. We're gonna cover this with a thin layer of shortening so that it doesn't stick to the plastic wrap. We're gonna place the fondant into a resealable bag, and then we wanna get out all of the air. Fondant's really particular with air. If you're ever not using it, it always wants to be stored. We're gonna put this in the fridge overnight, 12 hours at a minimum. I love working with fondant because it's so versatile and it looks super professional. So you can color it to whatever color your cake is or whatever color you want it to be. You can cover cakes with it, get a nice, smooth, and even finish. And you can even make little figurines. If you want to learn how to do any of those, click the links in the description box below. I'm Juliana. Thanks for watching.